Show tonight, St. Louis for you, 98 cents, Tommy John again. Two shows tomorrow at the Westport Funny Bone, full price, by the way. Three on Saturday, and then back to Los Angeles. He's in the studio. Ladies and gentlemen,
hey.
We give you Tommy John again.
Yeah, yeah. You just went through the whole week real quick.
I did.
Yeah. I'm already feeling like, oh, like home. I'm almost home. This is a, so we have this new baby on the way, and then we're done after this. We may be actually just done with any bedroom stuff, because I realized this. I am a male little spoon. It's a confession. I like to be the little spoon. I'm not a big spoon.
What,
when
you're
we spoon?
You're behind? What does that mean?
No, it means she spoons me. She's the big spoon.
Oh, she's too.
Oh, gotcha.
So I'm a male little spoon. I'm tired. I feel like I'm a feminist.
Yeah, right.
I feel like a woman can do anything a man can do, including holding me in the fetal position until I fall asleep. I'm done with this. Put down your apron and get in here and press your chest against my back until I fall asleep. I don't know what you're going to do with the other arm. It's not on me. You wanted equal rights. Well, you got them.
Have you ever tried to switch
I like curl up, and it doesn't make sense. She's not a big woman. Like, it would make sense if she was broad-shouldered and tall and looked like a mama bear holding her cub. It'd be beautiful. But if you walked in on us spooning, you would be confused. You'd be like, were you giving her a ride and you fell over? What is happening in here? Is this transgender? I'm Kate. I love being the little spoon.
Yeah,
I thought that was an Indian name. I'm little spoon.
I'm a little spoon. I think we need to get past this big spoon being the men.
Congratulations,
yeah.
By the way.
Yeah. That's really cool.
That took a lot.
You got to think about this, though. I mean, because in what, 2, 3, 4 years, these kids are going to be going to school.
I got a tiny kid. She's going to preschool starting in a month. I'm going to cry a bunch. And here's the thing I'm going to do. I'm going to overparent. I'm going to walk her in. I'm going to be there because you can't just leave these kids out to the wolves. When I was 13 years old, my mom was like, oh, he's 13. He's a big kid now. She just dropped me off at the doctor's office to go get my sports physical for school. And I went to a gynecologist for the sports physical. Spoiler alert, they don't do that there. They don't do a bunch of those. So I walked in. I go, I'm Tommy John again. I'm here for my appointment. And the woman goes, here, fill out this form.
She didn't even blame
you. You're either too stupid or too hilarious to work at a gynecologist's office if you give a 13-year-old boy a form. You should. As soon as a 13-year-old boy walks in, you should be like, hey, buddy, did you think we were showing him? So I walk in, and I sit there for 30 minutes. And then finally a nurse comes out, and she goes, why are you here? She weighs me. She does all these things. She finally asks me, goes, why are you here? Which is a question that should have come up earlier.
Sure.
I'm not
going
to tell you to run your business. But I go, I'm here for a sports physical. And she goes, did you know that this is an OBGYN's office? And I said, yes. Because I didn't know what she had just said. I was really putting all my chips on the fact that maybe she spelled gym wrong. Bought an extra vowel, forgot the M. This is a perfect day. And I forgot about it for like 10 years until one day it just occurred to me that somewhere in a gynecologist office there's a file with my name on it and my weight and a question mark next to, are you menstruating?